как говорят, поехали с орехами. As we say, let's go with the nuts. It's morning. And you double check last things. I just got text. Проверяем последние вещи. Получил text from Eric. Are you all good? Everything good? And you're up? And he's like, yes. Last things not to forget your comb and a screw. Последние вещи не забыть. Это расческу и шуруп. And a trusty chili sauce. Не забываем еще соус. Exciting time. Exciting time. Today is a big plan. It's Saturday morning. The plan is to get through Oregon. Сегодня суббота утро. План проехать Орегон. And actually get all the way to Salt Lake City and camp at a mine. Значит, проезжаем весь Орегон и доехать до города Salt Lake City, до шахты и там ночевать. So, stay tuned, keep watching, смотрите дальше. Road trip starting. Начинаем дорогу. На камере?
Да.
Yeah, look.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Just unique. Good morning, everybody. Всем доброе утро. Восход на Колумбия река. Река Колумбия, Колумбия река. Я уже как русско-английское неправильно говорю. So this is a beautiful sunrise pictures, views, start of our trip. 10 long days. No, short, they're gonna be short. 10 short days. 10 кратких дней путешествия начинается с такого восхода. Поэтому на удачу. Это называется Rowena, Rowena Road. Rowena Crest?
Rowena Crest.
Rowena Crest. Trail and road. This is a very popular spot to take pictures. Rowena Crest. Дорога называется. Очень популярное место брать, фотографировать здесь. Кто-то фотографирует восход, кто-то фотографирует закат. So some people like to take sunrise, some to take... So we're about right at sunrise time right now. Где-то сейчас вот восход у нас. Это река Колумбия. This is Columbia, and then it's Columbia Gorge. And I want to go fly a drone real quick.
Beautiful. It's a...
Good morning. Whoa. From Rowena Point, Columbia River Gorge. It's Saturday, and we're started our trip to Moab, and then on to Colorado, and we're headed out Interstate 84, and sun is coming up, so we wanted to share this with you. It's beautiful up here.
Гора Мэдамс, that's Adams, that's a Land Cruiser, and somewhere right there is Mount Hood behind those hills. This is about a new becoming YouTube star. It's gonna be Eric Swanson's Adventure Channel. Eric's got a good start, got a good rig, and he's starting it with the right trip. That's the beautiful part. So, восход, восход, sunrise, just beautiful. But I think I'm ready to go see more. So this is, we can come here more when we're home.
Alex is like, dude, shut up, let me record the video. Video recording a video.
I don't know why, but the video, man.
Driving down Rowena Crest. Just saw the sunrise. Look at that. Woo! beautiful. All right.
Gonna keep on driving. Got a long road ahead of us.
My co-pilot is yawning. Meet Vasily, the next YouTube star. So we're in, I think we're in Hood River. We have Hood River. At the pilot on 84. Here's the prices. So 310, 309 for regular fuel. You guys decided to catch some McDonald's breakfast. And what else? So this gas stations, a lot of people don't know. In Oregon, when you're out of the metro area in the smaller cities, smaller towns, you can fill up yourself. В Орегоне по закону нельзя заправляться самому. Тебя должны, ну, на заправке есть рабочие, которые обслуживают, да? Но в последнее время в некоторых маленьких городах сделали такую поправку, что получается, если город маленького населения, или вернее, скажем так, район, то там можно самому оперировать. So a lot of people were having an issue like, do I fill up or what do I do?
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, you're right. So actually, if you're driving down Oregon, this area, you just, you know, in smaller cities, whatnot, you can fill up yourself.
Quick overview of this side of Columbia Gorge. Вот такой вид на Колумбию отсюда. Здесь pricing, man. So 334 premium. So 92 у нас 360 примерно, это за галлон.
So the premium 92, octane is 360, right? Something. There's the bridge. That's the one that takes you to Washington. Это уже Вашингтон. Spin, little one. Spin, 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 spin. Really popular one lately in the gorge. Well, not lately, but I guess it's been for a while. But wind generation of electricity has become popular. Популярная вещь становится это. Мельница. So, and so, check your tire pressure, fill up on fuel, make sure all is good. Давление в шинах главное держать правильно. I'm running 44-45 PSI for the freeway to get a better fuel mileage. That's a beautiful truck.
It's a perfect overland vehicle, eh?
The tragedies of the road trip and the fun of it. 80 series Land Cruiser, 80-ка. It's giving us a little trouble. No. We're all good, we're all good. Hey, this is all part of the journey and adventure. But I'm not trying to put down the Toyota or anything. So the noise might be a little bit different. Eric is very well prepared, very well mechanically inclined. So we're gonna try to get this figured out. So we have a coolant leak right under the motor, one of the coolant hoses, I'm guessing. Is it like the heater core one?
No, it's a coolant bypass. It's underneath the intake, comes off the head.
Okay, so coolant bypass. Какая-то что-то с охлаждением шланга у нас потекла на 80-ке. So our goal is to figure out, troubleshoot, figure out. We're not too far from Baker City, and we're gonna try to see what we can do as far as getting us back on the road. Stay tuned. Дубль два. Let's try again. Land Cruiser has been Nixonized. I've actually helped fix it. So it's, the sticker's legit, right?
You fixed it.
Well, I helped. So it was an easy one. Let me get the lens. Я помог отремонтировать машину. Easy repair. The hose blew right kind of towards the end where it was fitted. So we just pulled it off, cut about an inch and a half off, put the clamp back on and stuck it on there, and we're done. It's good. Easy repair.
How long did that take?
5 minutes, whatever. But
how long?
If we have breakdowns, I wish they would be all like that. Let's just stick to that. Okay, let's get going. Something that really unpredictable and just can happen anytime to anybody. Что такое, что может произойти в любое время с любым человеком? You never know when, you know, something can go out. So one thing, benefit of going in a column. That's a Walla Walla onion truck right there. Walla Walla sweet onion truck just went by.
So one thing, benefit about traveling in a column, plus, когда путешествуешь в колонне, is that one can watch out for the other. So in our case, we could have run to the point where air got hot and Rick started smoking, and you never know what could have been happening, but in our case, I saw it just, you know, dripping a little bit. We're like, hey, Eric, something's not right. So we pull over, perfect timing, just a small issue. So, вовремя, вовремя поймали, вовремя отремонтировали. Все, собираемся, top it off with a little bit of fluid, coolant fluid. Make sure top it off with the blinker fluid and you're good to go.
Cheers. What we got going on? Filling up top enough water?
Yeah,
just making sure we have enough water for the trip in case something goes down. So looks like you're all good then?
Oh, absolutely.
So this is our second stop. We're in Baker City. Baker City Shell Jackson's truck stop. And off we go.
Водички набрали?
Все.
Водички набрали и едем дальше.
Brum, bum, bum, bum. Harley, I'm walking. The phone shakes.
So it seems like we're being caught in a little bit of a dust storm or something. We're roughly about 50 miles to the border of Idaho. Километра за 80 от границы со штатом Юта. Not from the border of Idaho, sorry, from Utah. So 80 километров от штата Юта границы. Нас поймало такой
ветрюган, пыль, ничего не видно. Там горы справа.
Но I'm driving with my steering wheel to the right, and that makes me driving straight. So really, really high side wind. And you can see that the trucks over there, the trailer, is going sideways a little bit even. So a little update on the road.
Фуру сдает он впереди нас. Триван такой, что еле-еле-еле.
Руль боком, короче.
Just outside of Salt Lake City, Utah. The weather is kind of interesting. The overcast, but the, man, the, it's warm. It's really warm inside.
So, Mr. Eric?
Yeah?
What were we doing in Salt Lake City?
What were we doing?
Yeah.
Oh, we had to stop by a Toyota dealership.
The dealership was very nice. They did what for us? They allowed Eric to purchase something over the phone and then left it with the sales department, right?
Yes.
So we could pick it up after hours. That was very nice. That was Larry H.
We found a faster route via Utah 48 West and Bacchus Highway,
you,
which
Google.
Saves 3 minutes. If you prefer to stay on the current route, tap no thanks.
Google is telling me directions right now. So we're going over to, I think it's called Bingham Mine Lookout. So, in Russian now, I'm trying to do dual language. So мы в Salt Lake City заезжали к дилеру на Toyota. Эрик брал там шлангу, которая у нас порвалась по дороге. И сейчас у нас цель карьер. Карьер Бингхэм, медный карьер. Вот, он должен быть, it's supposed to be like a mile deep. Должен быть about 2 kilometers, 2 kilometers где-то глубиной, about 1.6 kilometers, so that's about 2 kilometers. We'll exaggerate a little bit. It's okay. So it's gonna be deep. It's like a crater deep. So it's really smoky. Which is задымленно, smoky or dusty? What would you say?
More.
Both, yeah. So и пыль, и грязь, и дым как-то это самое. So we're hoping tomorrow for sunrise pictures and have a nice view. Надеемся, что завтра будет хороший вид. Все, Alex is back in the truck. Let's go. So right. We're going back the same way. Just staying on the same trail. Okay, stay tuned. Made it to the end of the series, or, I mean end of the episode. Вы досмотрели до конца серию, это прекрасно. So day was kind of rough. Quick wrap up. We did roughly about 850 miles. Так, обернем, как говорится, на вчерашний день. где-то, грубо говоря, 1400-1500 километров. Minor breakdown with Eric's 80. So he did some work on the motor himself, which is not a bad thing. У Эрика с 80-кой были какие-то проблемы. Он мотор недавно перебирал сам. Как бы он механик хороший, he's a good mechanic. But one of the hoses, which is normal, had a little blow on the end of it, the block. I guess it's a throttle body cooling hose. У нас была проблема у Эрика, значит, шланга. Шлангу прорвало на охлаждении. Throttle body. Я не знаю, как по-русски это. Я хотел Эрика спросить, а потом Эрик же по-русски не говорит. Ну, короче, маленькая охладительная шлангочка, которая идет с блока, где газ, педаль открывает заслоночное тело. О, я как-то так назову его. Anyways, and then we got to the Salt Lake City, pushed to Post Salt Lake City. We're here at 8:30. Мы в Salt Lake City были в 8:30 вечера. And dealership at Larry H. Miller. Thank you, Larry H. Guys, they stayed, well, they didn't stay open late for us, but they end up passing from the parts to the sales department, which I guess common thing, but still it's a good courtesy to us. Значит, дилерская Larry H. Miller, салон Toyota, Salt Lake City. Ребята с запчастей департамента передали, значит, отдела, вернее, передали продавцам маленькую запчасть, то есть нашу новую шлангу, на всякий случай, если ту еще дальше прорвет, чтобы у нас было чем менять. So now we have the part to repair with, and that's about it. And now we got up to a Bingham Outlook, which is there. Мы доехали до Bingham точки, где смотреть на эту на карьер. Но там было очень ветрено вчера, очень ветрено. I mean, it was like really wind. So очень. It's like really in Russian, right? So we're gonna start day two while you guys, I guess, finishing up day one. Thanks for watching. Cheers. Stay tuned.